say this. This song out here, the Christmas song, I played this for, I was writing a record. I was writing Gringo Honeymoon. And I'd written some really good songs. I was really happy with it, but I was kind of getting like frustrated with some stuff and just getting all caught up in like getting the right lyrics, the right melodies and things like that. And so just in an effort to just like forget about that all, I started thinking about, well, I got a little time here, this would work out. And then I realized, it was like the 1st of December, and you know, I lived in Nashville for a while, and I know one thing about Nashville, they just shut down September, man. I mean, they had Amazon back then. They had actually just boarded up all the houses and just sent all their crap to, you know, California or something. And so I was like really stuck thinking, damn, I'm never gonna finish this record because like there won't be anybody to record this stuff. And so I was kind of frustrated about the whole deal. So I started thinking about, man, Christmas, it just gets in the way. You get everything ready and then all of a sudden you can't do anything and everybody's talking about getting presents and all that business. And I thought, well, you know, I came from Houston and I didn't think that there was a Christmas song that represented Houston. I mean, I finally saw a chestnut in the HEB like 2 years ago, right? You know, and sleigh bells. I mean, you might as well have been saying that was some kind of thing like a rack for some kind of 15th century torture treatment, you know, sleigh bells, you know, you keep banging the bells until you're slain, you know, or whatever. I didn't know what the hell it was all about. So I never did connect with any Christmas song that I ever heard. And so I thought, well, hell, I need my own Christmas song. So I sat there and wrote this song, and I laughed my ass off every other line. I just thought I was the most clever person on the planet. But after I finished, I thought, well, nobody's gonna listen to this. This is stupid. So I played it for the, I played the whole record for the producer like a couple of days later, and he said, well, you got anything else? And producers love to say that. You could literally write, you know, you could write Hotel California, and they would say, you got anything else? So I had some pretty good songs. And he goes, well, we got anything else? I said, yeah, I got this weird little song about Christmas. He said, well, play that for me. I said, okay. And he's like laughing his ass off, man. And he said, that's the song. I said, well, you know, I mean, I don't want to be the Christmas guy. I just wanted to write a song for me. He says, oh, this song's great. And I said, really? He goes, oh, that's great. Because I never had a really good touch with how great songs were when I wrote them. I never knew. Even when I wrote The Road Goes On Forever, I had the two people I was playing that for just like their jaws dropped. And I said, what's so great about this song? Yeah. So I never had a real good scope on that kind of stuff. And anyway, I knew though that by this guy's reaction, because he's a pretty stoic guy, I knew that it had to have something going for it. So, you know, I kind of shaped it up, made it better. But the first time I really realized that it worked and it was really good was I came here to the Floore's Country Store and it was in the winter time and we weren't doing any of those Christmas shows or anything. It was just like, you know, December 12th or 13th. And I got up there and it was so cold, you had to be in the inside. So we're all in the inside. There's 500 or 600 people on the inside. It's all crowded and smoky. And it was a non-smoking deal, but it was still smoky. So what was going on with that? Anyway, so I played it and these people laughed their ass off. I thought, well, hell, this is good. And I thought, okay, I'll keep playing this. So we played it. And to the point where I got the distinct feeling that I would be hired in December just so people could hear that song. So I'd be playing it like y'all. I mean, some of y'all might experience this. I'd be playing to regular audience and they'd be talking, shooting the shit and all this stuff. And nothing would happen. They didn't care. And all of a sudden I'd start playing that Christmas song and everybody's like, ah, and screaming. I was like, this is just a different kind of song, man. That's all it is.
Yeah.
Christmas party. We were drinking champagne punch and homemade eggnog. Little sister brought her new boyfriend. He was a Mexican. When I want to think of him, tell his sign. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad. Brother Ken brought his kids with him. The three from his first wife, Lynn. And the two identical twins from his second wife, Mary Nell. He brought his new wife, Kay. He talks all about chain smoking while the stereo plays. Noel, Noel, the first Noel. Caught the turkey, turned the ball game on. Drove from Harlingen. Can't remember how I came to them. When I tried to plug her motor home and they blew out Christmas lights. Cousin David knew just what went wrong. Oh.